The pattern of disturbances may be of two types, and we can say there are two methods of formation of waves. See one method. This method we will call the waves which are made are transverse waves. Transverse waves. These waves are generated at surface. What is meant by at surface? Like there is a water in the pond, water, and here is air. So this interface between the two is known as surface. If I create a disturbance here, just throw a stone in the water and these molecules go up and down. They start oscillating here. Then due to intermolecular force, this will start dancing. Then this will start oscillating. This will start oscillating. And finally, what we find that this particle is oscillating. So this is the wave is carried from this point to this point. That is, the disturbance is carried from this point to this point. Now, what type of disturbance it is and where it is? So it is on the surface of two mediums. Here, the vibrations and the direction of disturbance propagation. What that word means. Here is the disturbance. After a moment, here is the disturbance. After a moment of here, after a moment here. So what is this direction? This direction is known as direction of the wave propagation. Direction in which the disturbance is moving. Direction in which the energy is moving. So we call it direction of propagation of the wave. Wave. Okay. Then what is this direction? This direction is direction of oscillation of particle. Direction of oscillation of particle. Now you see the relation here. The direction of wave and the direction of oscillation, they are perpendicular to each other. When this condition is there, that oscillation and propagation, they are at right angle to each other, then the waves are known as transverse wave. I will write it. Oscillations and propagation. Are at right angle to each other. Okay, then these are transversal waves. In transversal waves, the mechanism that we have already explained during the formation of wave in the previous lecture. And whenever we click a photograph of the particles, we get the particles here, 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 like this. And it continuously keeps on moving. Crest is here, then crest will be here, then crest will be here. This particle is at the top, then this particle is at the top, then this particle is at the top. So at every moment, the next particle comes to the top. So, if I put my hand here and it is like this, if it is stretched here this way and I put my hand here and you see, the crest is moving left, the crest is moving towards right. This is what's happening in the wave and the crest is moving. But what's happening actually with the particle? The particle is oscillating at its own place. Is the particle moving? Answer, no. Medium does not move. It is simply oscillating at its place. And that comes as a part of definition we have seen, that there will be carrying over of, there will be transmission of energy and vibration. But material will remain at its own place. Okay, so this is transverse wave. In transverse wave, the particle which is at the highest point, this is known as crest of wave. Not this particle is crest of wave. At this pattern, this is crest of wave, this is crest of wave, but after one moment, we will call this is crest of wave. After next moment, this is crest of wave. So crest keeps on moving. Crest keeps on moving. That is, the location of maximum disturbance keeps on moving. Here, 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 and finally here. This location gets maximum disturbance. So this is the crest is moving. The lowest part we give the name as trough. Just by looking to it, this is crest, this is trough. And here, this particle at this moment is at one extreme of the oscillation, and this particle which is oscillating, it is at the other end of the oscillation. Okay, so particles are oscillating one after the other. After this, this particle will oscillate and go up. So in any wave, what we find that, and this is very important and you should understand it very well, that if at any time I take the photograph of the particle and I get the particle in this shape, then all the particles are oscillating. But what is their direction of oscillation at this time? If I ask you, this particle at the next instant, is it moving up or it is moving down? So the first thing you will ask me, whether the wave is going towards right or left. I say the wave is going towards right. That means the next peak or the next crest will be here. Who will make it? This will make it. So that means this is going up. That is all. That is why after one moment it will make a crest like this. That means this is also moving up. This is moving up. After that, this will make the crest. After that, this will make the crest. After that, this will make the crest. So all these particles are moving up. Here to here. What about this? This is a trough and this trough also keeps on moving. So if this trough is here, after one instant, this trough will be here. So this trough will be here. How it will be here? Because this particle will come here. That means at this moment, this particle is oscillating down. This is oscillating down, oscillating down, oscillating down, and this is oscillating down. So half of the particle are oscillating up, half of the particle are oscillating down. See, they will go down, this will go up, so the crest will be here, and the trough, because of them, trough will be here. So please remember this diagram, and this give you instantaneously that at what phase of their oscillation they are. This phase, whether it is upward or downward. So this is how it will move up. So this is a transverse wave. In the transverse wave, we have certain terminology, that is the maximum displacement is known as amplitude. All are the same words what you have heard previously. This is amplitude of the wave. Okay. Now, here to here, one cycle is completed. So this is one wave or one cycle of the wave. Now, this to this, in one cycle, the disturbance has gone from this point to this point, one wave is complete. So this length from here to here, this is known as one wavelength. One wavelength. And we give it a name, lambda. So this may be here to here. The same length we can calculate here. from any one crest to the other crest, it will be the same length, lambda. 0 here, the wave is rising. Here, the wave is rising. Any two point of the same phase, this distance is wavelength, lambda. Crest to crest, same phase, lambda. Trough to trough, lambda. 0 to 0, lambda. Any two same faces, like this is coming, this is going up, this is also going up, the next one. So this length is also lambda. So for wavelength, we can write a definition that wavelength is the distance between two points of the same phase. Okay, then whatever time is taken from this point to this point, that is time period T, and in 1 second the number of waves made are known as number of waves. How many waves will be made depends upon how many oscillations this particle is making. So both are the same thing, number of waves or number of oscillations. These two are called frequency. Frequency nu. Okay, during one cycle, how much is change in the phase? This you have seen in the oscillation. From here, the circulating point change the phase by 2 pi, and this makes one oscillation. So during one oscillation, the phase change is supposed to be 2 pi, and this is one oscillation, the phase change is 2 pi. So in new oscillation, how much will be the angular displacement, or the angular displacement per second, what we call it, angular velocity. Angular velocity, its name is omega. This is this frequency multiplied by 2 pi. This we call angular velocity as well as angular frequency. Because in one cycle it makes 2 pi angle. So in new cycles it will make 2 pi multiplied by new angle. This is frequency multiplied by angle is angular frequency. Okay. With the distance we make it angular velocity, both are same thing, please remember. And that is omega 2 pi nu, and the other format of omega we know, it is 2 pi upon t, because t is equal to 1 upon frequency. So time period of the wave, frequency of the wave, angular frequency of the wave, amplitude of the wave, a. These are certain terms which we have just seen, and the wavelength, very important. So these are the important terms of a wave, what one should remember. Now, can we find out velocity with this? Answer is yes. Velocity in one cycle it will move lambda, and in 1 second how much distance it will move, lambda, 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 how many cycles, new cycles. So in 1 second the total distance moved is nu multiplied by lambda, and that is velocity. So we have a formula of velocity, nu into lambda. So these are certain basic terms, and this is type of transverse waves. Now the other type of wave, that is known as longitudinal wave, that we will study in the next lecture. Thank you.